Hello and welcome back to Wood Gas Stove Science. This is the paint can optimization series. In this episode, I will be testing the ratios of primary to secondary air inlets. So once you've optimized your secondary air inlets and can produce enough flow through them to produce a flame cap that it can fully enclose the combustion zone and create a complete oxygen-free paralysis zone, you can start to optimize the primary inlets. So you get a smoke and soot-free burn. We do this by slowly increasing the amount of airflow through the primary holes. And as you just saw, this first burn has a 1-to-1 primary to secondary air ratio, which means we have equal volume of air inlets in both the primary and secondary systems. I built a new internal can and start with the 16 primary holes in the bottom of the can, and then 16 secondary holes in the top of the can just under the rim. These 16 secondary holes have been tweaked to give the flame a spinning vortex to help close off the paralysis zone. So what you've just seen is a quick boil test. This boil test took about 9 minutes for this to boil with this 1-to-1 flame ratio. And you can see there's an excessive amount of soot on the bottom of the can. There's actually even a little bit of tar buildup on the bottom. And you can see that by me wiping it off with a fresh paper towel. The vortex was still very good, but at the end of the burn, there was a lot of smoke, and there was actually even some smoke during the burn. So you can't really see it because it's kind of a windy day, but as soon as this flame goes out, there is a big puff of smoke, and the change from that paralysis type of burning to when it starts to consume the charcoal, it's smoked for quite a few minutes before it started to just burn the charcoal. There you can see that I dumped the charcoal out so I could see how much charcoal was left, and there was a lot of charcoal left in that burn. So with fewer primary air holes, you actually produce more charcoal, but don't get quite as much of a clean burn. So here you can see that I increased the amount of holes, the primary holes, to 32. So now we have a 2-to-1 primary to secondary air ratio. And you can see I'm using just a capful of liquid heat in the yellow bottle. And I'm doing that because quite a few people had mentioned that I was using an accelerant, and they thought maybe that accelerant was causing a really good burn. So I reduced that amount down to just a capful. Here you can see that the burn took about 8 minutes, as opposed to the previous burn that took a boil that took about 7 minutes. And you can see that the amount of soot on the bottom of the can was much less. It was still sooty, and it was still kind of greasy feeling, but it was much less. And each time I'm using a paper towel that is fresh. So you can see here, I still have a nice vortex spinning. The flame seemed to be a little bit more powerful. And there was a little bit less smoke that came out of this when it converted from that pyrolysis to consuming charcoal. So here again, I increased the number of primary air holes from 32 up to 48. So now I'm sitting at a 3-to-1 ratio, using the same amount of pellets, using the same amount of liquid heat. So one thing I just alluded to, which I don't think I've talked about in any previous videos, is that once the burn is over, once the fuel has been consumed and all that's left is char or charcoal at the end, I've been really striving to get a smooth transition between that pyrolysis type of burn where all of that material is being reduced down to its lowest, just char or carbon, and then to when the flame switches over to burning the charcoal. And by doing that, I don't want a lot of smoke when that happens. So there you can see that my burn time was like 7.5, my boil time was about 7.5 minutes. I didn't produce nearly as much soot. It's actually starting to look very good. And there was little to no smoke at the end. So it's very obvious that increasing this primary air is really starting to give me a lot cleaner burn. So here I've added 16 more holes, and now I've got a nice 4-to-1 ratio of primary to secondary holes, and I'm using the same parameters, the 1 cup of wood pellets, and the little tiny capful of liquid heat in the yellow bottle. And here you can see that the boil time is just over 7 minutes. And it's a little bit tough because it's a windy day, but here you can see there's virtually no soot, a very, very small amount of soot. The spinning vortex is very good. The burn time is just a hair shorter, starting to get down to in the 21 to 22 minutes. But here I've cut back to just a view of the last burn, so we can talk about this a little bit. So now let's just recap what we saw in the last four experiments that I did. So in the first burn, which was a 1-to-1 ratio, we saw a boil time, which was started at about 6 minutes into the burn, and we saw a boil time of around 9 minutes, 9.5 minutes. Now, this burn time could have been a little bit shorter because I did not put a cover on this pan. So the second burn, which was 2-to-1, had a boil time of about 8 minutes, which was a pretty good improvement. The next boil was about 3-to-1, and that boiled in about 7.5 minutes. And the one that was 4-to-1 boiled in about 7 minutes, little under 7.5 minutes. So the same thing happened with the 1-to-1 ratio. We got a lot of soot on the bottom of the can, and even a little bit of tar, which is a sticky substance. And we went to 2-to-1 and then 3-to-1. And by the time we get to 4-to-1, we had minimal amount of soot on the bottom of the pan, which is great. The time to exhaust the flame varied anywhere from 23 minutes down to 21.5 minutes. And that sort of reduced from that 1-to-1 ratio down to that 4-to-1 ratio. And so then we can talk about the conversion over to burning the charcoal. All three stoves did do that conversion smoothly over, but the 1-to-1 ratio smoked a lot in that conversion, and the number 2 smoked, the number 3 also smoked, and then that 4-to-1 ratio actually did a very, very nice job, and there was no smoke throughout the whole burn, and that conversion was smooth. And what happens during that conversion is your temperature, so if you happen to be cooking on it when that conversion occurs, your temperature is going to drop off rapidly, but then as the charcoal starts to get more airflow through it, it really starts to pick up, and you can actually almost get back to a boil, and that is usually a 15 to a 20 minute time where that charcoal is burning. So hopefully this helped explain something about those ratios. A lot of people have asked questions about those ratios, and this is how I got to the 4 or 5-to-1 ratio with most of my can stoves. So thank you very much for viewing, and have a great day. Goodbye.